Mr. Timothy Ferdinand is hoping that following the debate by the National Youth Council on Tuesday, August 6, local politicians will follow suit and agree to debate each other ahead of the next general elections. Political debates have the potential to make a small but real impact on the elections, and as such, local candidates opt not to take part in such activities. Candidates through a debate will have the opportunity to face each other before the general public in an attempt to sway voters in their favor.
I think if our politicians can actually go that step further, one step further in terms of having those civilized debates between themselves, it would mean that our political culture is up for good change. Unless we can see that happening, I cannot be optimistic that our politics will change. We need to go beyond the delivery of a manifesto a couple of days before election. We need to go beyond the back and forth via the media. We need to go beyond the parliament sessions where you have the back and forth. We need to see our opposing parties stepping up, presenting their ideas and debating it, and accepting advice or criticism from each other in a more structured way, as opposed to the media being used to fight or to break down or to support.
The former NYC president is calling on the local politicians to take a page from the NYC's book, as those seeking to head the organization face each other in a public debate.
Tomorrow evening we will be hearing from the three candidates who are vying for the position of president of the National Youth Council. The National Youth Council is crying out for leadership. Leaders who are able to really advance the organization. And so we have three persons going up, and we have organized a live debate in collaboration with NTN Studios, GIS, tomorrow from 5:30. So the candidates will be asked questions, allowed to debate. They will also be faced with questions from the floor as well as on Facebook and so on. So we really want to expose St. Lucia to the persons who are putting themselves forward to lead the NYC, because we are in a time now where we really need to hear the National Youth Council speaking out on behalf of young persons.
In the past, organizations such as the St. Lucia Chamber of Commerce, Industry and Agriculture have encouraged such debates but were unsuccessful in getting candidates to agree. For the DBS News World, I am Sheffield Gillard.